Hello students, in this lecture we will take new topic scalar and vector magnetic potential. So in the previous lecture we have taken boundary conditions for the magnetostatics. So detailed diagram for boundary conditions we have taken, that is for normal component and for tangential component we have derived boundary conditions. So in this lecture we will derive scalar and vector magnetic potential. So first scalar magnetic potential. So in electrostatic field we have seen that one relation between E and V. So what is the relation between E and V? E is equal to minus of grad V. So in for magnetic field we can write down this relation, E is equal to minus of grad Vm, okay, where Vm is a scalar potential. Similarly, scalar magnetic potential for magnetic field can be defined as H bar is equal to minus of del Vm. Okay, so this is for electrostatic field and this is for magnetic field. Only E ki jaga H bar mention karo, equation is the same, H bar is equal to minus of grad Vm. So take curl both sides of above equation. So taking curl, curl means del cross H is equal to del cross minus of del Vm. So we have taken curl. Curl of magnetic field intensity is a current density, means del cross H is equal to J, and curl of gradient of any scalar is 0. Curl of gradient of any scalar is 0, means this term is a 0. Hence current density must be 0 throughout the region in which scalar potential is to be defined, means del cross H is equal to J is equal to 0. But as we have already defined, H bar is equal to minus of grad Vm. Therefore, H bar is equal to minus of grad Vm, J bar is equal to 0. Okay, so to scalar magnetic potential is also defined as scalar magnetic potential. So in the second chapter, potential is there, that is potential difference between two points is given by minus of B to A EDL. So in terms of magnetic field, that formula is changed, that is a VAP, potential difference between two points is given by initial point minus B to integral minus B to A HDL. Okay, so if you have attended previous lecture, then this formula you can recall, that is a potential difference between two points, VAB is equal to minus of B to A EDL tha, to yaha pe HDL for magnetic field we have mentioned. This equation is applicable for any specified path. The scalar potential also satisfies Laplace's equation. So from Maxwell's second equation, we have equation del dot B is equal to 0. So if you observe, some of the equations comes directly in this subject. So if you attended all the lectures, then you can understood this is one of the relation, Maxwell's second equation del dot B is equal to 0. But what is the relation between B and H? B is equal to mu H. So B is equal to mu H. Therefore, del dot B, you can represent it as a del dot of mu H, means only B ka value you have to fill up karo, we will get del is equal, means del dot B is equal to del dot mu H. Okay, so 0 is equal to del mu minus of grad Vm. So put the value of H from this equation or above equation, minus of del Vm. So put the value of gradient minus grad Vm of this, that H value here we have fill up. Okay, so if we observe here, del dot of del is a del square, mu is the same, therefore the above equation can be written as minus of mu del square Vm. So this equation can also be represented as del square Vm is equal to 0. So which is called as a scalar magnetic potential, del square Vm is equal to 0. So we have derived expression for scalar magnetic potential. Expression is easy if you know the relation between E and V, E is equal to minus grad Vm, H for similarly for H, write down equation, H is equal to minus of grad Vm. Then we know that potential difference between two points for magnetic field can be given by this formula, okay. But one formula is del dot, that is divergence of magnetic flux density is equal to zero. So B is equal to, we can write mu H, put that value, again put the value of H, H is equal to minus of grad Vm, and by solving we will get this equation. And next, vector magnetic potential. The scalar magnetic potential may be used in the regions where the current density is zero, but vector magnetic potential may be used in the region where the current density J is zero or non-zero. The vector magnetic potential A bar is defined as del cross A bar is equal to B bar. Okay, so put the value of here B, that is the relation between B and H. What is the relation? B is equal to mu H, or we can write mu zero H. Okay, so from this expression find the value of H bar. So this mu 0 goes to this side, therefore H bar is equal to 1 upon mu 0 del cross A bar. Next, therefore del cross H bar is equal to J is equal to 1 upon mu 0 del cross A. So taking curl both sides in this equation, del cross H is equal to क्या रहता है, J रहता है current density, and is equal to 1 upon mu 0 del cross A. Unit of A is Weber's per meter. The source for the vector potential is a current which flows through the filament DL. The vector potential at a distance r from filament is given by this formula, A bar is equal to close integral mu 0 IDL upon 4 pi r. So this is also direct equation here. Vector potential at distance r from the filament is given by A bar is equal to mu 0 IDL upon 4 pi r. Okay, so you can mention if K is the surface current density for a current sheet, then IDL is equal to KDS. So put the value of this IDL is equal to KDS, and then that equation becomes A bar is equal to S, surface integral mu 0 KDS upon 4 pi r. If J bar is the current density for the volume dV, dV, then IDL can be written as IDL is equal to JdV. Okay, in terms of current density, we have to write down IDL is equal to JdV. So KDS ki jagah put the value JdV. Therefore, A bar or A is equal to volume integral mu 0 JdV upon 4 pi r. Okay, so this is a final expression. That is for the this vector magnetic potential A is equal to volume integral mu 0 J dV upon 4 pi r. Okay, so these expressions are used in the antenna theory also. So to antenna analysis, we have to find out or represent vector magnetic potential A bar. So in the final year in the radiation and microwave technique subject, for the antenna analysis, that is antenna analysis of dipole, infinitesimal dipole, finite length dipole, in that this vector magnetic potential equations we have to write down, and we have to analyze antennas. Okay, so in this lecture we have mentioned scalar and vector magnetic potential in detail. So in sometimes in exam, write short note on vector and scalar magnetic potential. Such type of question is asked, or derive expression for scalar and vector magnetic potential for 6 marks. Okay, so we have derived this expression. So we will stop here, and in the next lecture we will take another topic on this third chapter, and only 1 to 2 bits are remaining, and some problems we have to take on this chapter, and almost third chapter is also in the means at the ending stage. Okay, thank you. We'll stop here.